Okay, so you know, we just have one lesson that covers law, ethics, and privacy. So we're not talking about any of these in great detail. As you said, I only talked about two of the laws. Didn't even get to privacy. But we do want to very briefly talk about sort of ethics related to our online activities. So what's the difference between laws and ethics? We know that ethics have to do with sort of, you know, an individual's sense of what is right and wrong. On the other hand, laws are sort of societal. You know, we as a society decide, state, local, or federal, whatever it is, laws that, you know, say what is wrong. If you did that, you would have certain kind of sanctions. Laws may not cover certain things, but your sense of right and wrong might say, well, I should not be doing this. And we're talking about that in the context of, you know, what we do online or what we do in cyberspace. Before we sort of go further, it's worthwhile pointing out that when it comes to your ethical sort of your sense of right and wrong, of course, there is no external arbiter or enforcement agency like law, where we have, you know, the police and the courts and things like that. So what's sort of the example of an ethical code that you could think about? So what happens? You discover a vulnerability in a commercial product that's used by lots and lots of people. What is ethical disclosure of this vulnerability? Okay, so here is the idea and the dilemma. So if you disclose it, it's disclosed to even the bad guys. So the bad guys can then exploit it and then can go and attack the system in which you have discovered a vulnerability. Okay, so that says maybe, you know, disclosing it is not a great thing. The other way to think about this is that if you don't disclose it, that doesn't mean the bad guys actually won't find out about it. And if you don't disclose it, then there's no pressure on the vendor who actually produced this commercial system or product to actually do something about it. Okay, so by disclosing, you're sort of fixing this problem or vulnerability we have, hopefully in a timely fashion. But at the same time, you're also making this, you know, information available to bad guys. So that's where, you know, where do you draw the line? What's the ethical thing to do here? So of course, we have our personal notion of right and wrong. So it could be sort of your personal thing, or it could be you know, ethical conduct defined by some professional society that you may be a member of. So ACM or IEEE, or even Georgia Tech. So ethical standards or, you know, code of conduct, doing the right thing, knowing what's right and what is wrong. Of course, laws and ethics go together to help us understand, you know, what is that we can do without doing anything illegal or doing anything wrong, versus, you know, what is that should not be done because that's the wrong thing to do.